Today we're going to review a lifetime deal that's an image and video enhancer. It's called BoolTool, and we're going to review the good and the bad about it with no BS. Let's go jump over to my desktop right now. Let's start by reviewing the deal that's going on right now. So it starts off at $29 and it's on a lifetime deal. So that means you pay once and use it forever. Let me show you what that gets you. And right now that link is provided in the description in case you want to grab it. So first of all, you're going to get included all these features in the plan. So all the basics, so background remover, background blur, effects, animation effects, resize, compression, etc. Now, license tier 1, which is $29, I think it's a pretty sweet deal. 10 batch processing, that means that you can upload up to 10 photos for batch processing. And in license tier 2, you get unlimited batch processing. Now, my recommendation, if you were to grab this, is the $69 deal. I wouldn't even touch a $29 deal unless you don't care about the minutes for the video enhancement. And I do like this tool. So if you want to do this for videos, jump into license tier 2. Now, let's jump into the actual tool. Now, one of the first things that I dislike about BoolTool is that they don't have a clean dashboard interface. So basically, this is like the main site. And if you want to use one of their tools, you hover over the menu right here and we can select it. For example, object eraser. I can go ahead and select it and it takes me directly to the actual place where I'm going to use it. Now, if I hover over here, I get all the tools also. But there's no, for example, kind of history. There's no dashboard to view this in a nice, clean way. So they need to improve the user experience for this. Now, let's start with the video enhancer tool, which works pretty well. Now, there are some drawbacks. What are these? Well, that it's capped at a video of 1080p by 1080p. So first of all, it's capped. You can't use 4K. And second, it has to be a squared video, 1080p by 1080p or lower, all right? But in this case, I would like at least to have 1080p by 720p, at least because it would be rectangular, like the one you're watching right now. But that's not available, so it has to be a square one. If they implement that in the future, this would be a really, really great tool. Now, does it work? Yes, it does enhance. Now, let me show you in this demo video that I've tested, and you're gonna see side by side right here. Let me show. In this painting right here, you see this little boats right here on the water? You're gonna see it's much better over here on the right. It has a better tone of color, and it's more precise. It's crispier, right? And you're also gonna see on my beard, how you can see how it's kind of blurry around here. And here it's a little bit more defined. So that's pretty good. In the skin, it also defines a little bit more, which is not always best. And on the right, you're also gonna see on the buildings, you see better color and more precise. Now on the top, you can see there's a brand on my air conditioner, which is York. And you're gonna see that's a bit more precise. Whoops, I clicked play on this. It's more precise on the right. Now I'm gonna move the video so you can see the other letter in here, which is triple inverter. You can see that there. Let me move this. There we go. Also, where it says triple inverter, you can see that it's also more clear on the enhanced version of the video. So you can see it does work in that sense, but you have those drawbacks of the 1080p by 1080p cap, okay? Now, once you download this, you're gonna view it here on the right. And you can go ahead and download the video once you render it, and it's gonna deduct from the 60 minutes that you have available. Now be aware that on the preview, you're only going to preview 4 seconds, but it doesn't mean that it's gonna be capped there. So this is a 20 second video. You can go ahead and download the whole thing over here. Now, other tools the BoolTool has is, for example, the photo animation. This is the photo animation. You basically upload a photo and you get some of these animations, which I think, they're pretty okay. They're standard. I don't think they're something fancy, but maybe if you have a cool image where there's some snow on the back and you add this, well, that might be pretty cool. Nothing fancy about it. I've seen this a lot on phone apps where you can do this. So not the best tool I've seen. Background remover. They have this one also available. It works okay. There are some things that could be implemented that could make it great. For now, it's just a background remover and it works kind of okay. So right here, this is one of the tests I've done and you can see that this is not correct. I think that's for my chair. So it doesn't remove it correctly. I can go ahead and edit this and I can use the erase and repair tool. If I use a repair tool, it's gonna bring back the background. If I use the erase, well, it's gonna erase what I select. I wish this was a smart erase where I just click on this section and it'll kind of detect what I want to erase. So it doesn't work that way. So it's kind of basic in that sense. I can go ahead and reset it and erase that section and it's good to go. But I mean, that's an easy fix. If this was something more complex, it would take a ton of time to kind of fix it. Once you're good, you can do an AI generated background, and they'll generate some backgrounds that might be useful to you, which you can select here, or maybe color. There you go. And you can go ahead and upload another background if you like, or if you use one of these, you can just go ahead and download it, which is all right. Another tool that they have is the object eraser. So just like Photoshop, you select some objects. For example, this light switch right here that I have in the background. I'll go ahead and select it. It'll start working. I dislike that pulse section that they do. I mean, that's kind of, you know that it's working, but I kind of dislike it. So let's wait for it to erase that. There we go. It just erased it. So the tool works fine in that sense. It wasn't complex, but it does work for a little bit more complex images. So that's a cool tool. Another one that they have is the image enhancer. So just like the video, it also enhances images. So let's check this out. Now I see this plaque on YouTube. You can see that it's more clear on the right. You can see how YouTube is more defined than on the left. Over here it's blurry, and over here it's better. Also the camera, there's a little camera here. You can see it's also a little bit more defined. Also, I like the detail on the gradient. So there's some pink here on the left. Here's the original and here's the enhanced one. So it makes it much nicer. You can see that there, it's a nice gradient. And on my face, there's a little bit more definition on my beard. And basically it does enhance the image. So it works pretty fine in that sense. The other tool they have is the AI paraphraser, and they have some sugar comments and photo storytelling, and that's about it. For example, I just made this test, but basically this is not the main focus, the AI writer thing, but they have it and it's available. But that is BoolTool. I mean, if you like the video enhancer and you are okay with the square version, then this is a good tool to grab. But if you make videos like I do, rectangular ones, then maybe you want to skip on this. I mean, for this price, I think it's a sweet deal, but it's up to you that if you're going to take advantage of this tool or not. I wish they implement API access so we can do automations and enhance the images on automation, on autopilot, instead of going there and doing it manually. They have to fix the dashboard, make it a nice user experience, and not what they have right now. But if you want to grab this deal, the link will be provided in the description. And that's a wrap.